And while the cold and flu has knocked a lot of people off their feet, the need for a fresh supply of blood and plasma donations never ends. People's lives depend on those donations.
It's why KCRA3 and Blood Source are teaming up once again tomorrow and Saturday for the annual Blood Drive for Life. KCRA3's Tony Valliere shows us how the kindness of strangers saved an Elk Grove teenager's life.
AJ, we gotta stop him over here.
Ashley Vanderpan kicks off the new year in gratitude for the good things in her life. Her family, a promising future in college-level volleyball, and a second chance at life following a battle with a rare autoimmune disease. It was the fall of 2016. What started as a lingering cough turned to a medical emergency.
I was in an ambulance, and I was put on like a ventilator, just to, like, to push oxygen into my lungs because I couldn't breathe on my own. I just kind of see a doctor pull my mom away. And I could just tell when my mom got pulled off that I knew something wasn't right.
In a nightmare Sleeping Beauty scenario, Ashley lay in an induced coma for 2 months, fighting for her life.
Once I got out of my coma, I was on a lot of drugs and I was still being weaned off a lot of them.
Another 2 months of treatments and recovery would follow.
And even through my whole rehab process, I had a chest tube in. I was going on walks with something dangling from my body.
Always her family by her side.
As things were happening, just never thought that the diagnosis would be so severe.
Just appreciate every day. And, you know, we know, you know, she's going to come out of this and, you know, she's going to do well. You know, we'll watch things a little more carefully, but we've got a lot of good people around us.
Also on her side, like a silent army of supporters, were countless blood and plasma donors.
Just the volume of blood products, you know, that were going to be required. You know, we knew that she was on a schedule of getting, you know, this plasmapheresis interchange, which was every just couple few days and almost a gallon each time it happened.
She actually received almost 300 units of blood products over the whole course of her stay.
That's 37 gallons of blood products.
These products not only helped with the procedures they were doing, but also to help fight the disease.
It came from family, friends, and strangers.
I think that she should deserve that blood because I got her back really fast, and because my goal for her is to do sports and everything and getting back to life.
Today, Ashley's disease is in remission. She's headed to Syracuse University, where she hopes to continue her volleyball career. Always grateful for those who gave her the gift of life.
Words can't describe how thankful I am because it really saved my life.
Tony Valliere, KCRA 3 News.
See, just an example of like someone you could be helping. Ashley's journey's not over yet. Tonight at 6, the next step that will help Ashley on her road to recovery.
And you can help Ashley and other families fighting medical emergencies by giving the gift of life at our KCRA3 Blood Drive for Life.
Yes, this Friday. Tomorrow, we'll be collecting donations at 2 locations from 6 in the morning until 6 at night in Sacramento at the Central YMCA at 2021 W Street. We're also taking donations at the Roseville Sports Center on Pleasant Grove Boulevard. And then on Saturday, we'll be back at the Roseville location from 9 to 5.